Greetings, fellow Oaklands. Welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission, hopefully the final mission of the Indonesia campaign, unless there's one more mission here, would be Operation Lockdown. I'm assuming it's the final mission because there are no more missions unlocked on the map. However, there was a statement in the debriefing of Shutdown where it said that they had acquired the location of yet another base camp, terrorist base camp, where they were storing the virus samples stolen from CDC, the disease samples. So maybe there is another mission, maybe this is the final mission, let's see. All will be clear at the end of this video. So anyway, let's just go ahead and see what lockdown is. The objective is simple, capturing a target, or rather killing. Pretty straightforward, there are literally just three, objective markers here. Mission, capture the commander of a terrorist base designated objective Moo. Execution, your insertion point is approximately 500 meters north of objective Moo. Proceed south through your checkpoints. Eliminate any perimeter guards you encounter, then proceed to the objective. Pacify all resistance at the objective before you move in and secure the terrorist commander. Success of this mission depends on capturing the base commander alive. I'm guessing that we don't exactly have to capture him per se. It's sort of like the final mission to kill the Peru campaign. Expected enemy forces, there of course will be a lot of enemies. All source intelligence collected by J2 suggests that this is one of the two primary terrorist bases. As such, it is expected to house a company sized force. An entire company, okay. How many platoons are there in the company, I wonder? While there has been no indication of heavy weapons or air support at the base, the perimeter patrols are extremely heavy and cautious. Caution should be exercised while approaching the base. Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted approximately 700 meters northeast of the objective, somewhere around here. They will move into position to suppress any enemy forces moving out of the base from the northwest. Alright. So basically we are alone in the base, thus far I suppose. Charlie team will be inserted into a position approximately southwest, 700 meters southwest of the objective. So basically, yeah, they don't exactly want a situation where Alpha and Charlie might, you know, catch each other in the crossfire. So I'm assuming they would probably set up a perimeter here. Perimeter being a very loose term because there are only two people to catch all the escaping bastards. Pardon my French. They are tasked with eliminating all southern perimeter guards and then moving forward in support of your assault from the hills south of the objective. So I'll be assaulting sort of from the northwest. They will be coming in from the southwest. Alright. Not bad. Situation. Interrogation of the IMT forces which survived their assault on the Indonesian president have revealed the location of IMT's main operations and planning base. All source intelligence suggests that the leader of the IMT is currently at that base. Capture of their leader would cripple IMT activities both within Indonesia and worldwide. Further, questioning the leader would definitely lead to the discovery of the location of stolen CDC material. So see, in fact, this is not the final mission in the Indonesian campaign. We have got one more mission which shall reveal itself after this, I suppose. Now it's curious that they are suggesting that I opt for the sniper rifle in this mission, but I don't particularly dislike this, so I will stick to it. Just one change that I'm gonna make is go ahead and change this up to the Spec Ops 45, because that is a far more powerful gun. And since stealth doesn't really seem to be a big criteria for this mission, all the better for me. Let's go ahead and start this up. So, addendum 5, it's so
Bravo strange. Team, move into the camp. Alpha and Charlie, secure the perimeter.
Roger, King 6. Now, what I find Roger, sort of King strange 6. Is how every single time that I've wiped out all the enemies from the map, I've ended up, you know, losing the mission. So, makes me wonder if there are, like, if I'm accidentally killing the objective in one of the who's actually conveniently located in one of the houses. And that would be a real shame, to be honest, knowing that I've been sabotaging my own success in this mission all this while. If only they gave us flash grenades, which we could actually utilize to
This is Alpha. We have observed heavy patrolling along this route.
Make arrangements. But they don't. They give us only fragmentation plates. So I'm going to try and, basically check the houses out. I mean, at least the ones that are not shooting at me. Because I think...
There's a bunker on the north ridge. I count two shooters.
If one of them, of course, if they are trying to shoot at me, then I do suspect that one of these houses actually houses the target that we are after. So, yeah, I'll basically try to get the target with as little bloodshed as possible this time. Basically, what I'm trying to say is I'll try not to kill the target. And I do suspect I'll be doing that on the side. So, it's basically that... How did the bullet not hit you, son? Yeah, so... nice. So, it's basically that house that I think has the prisoner, either this one or that one, either of those two. And that's basically the leader, IMT leader. I don't know whether that's the leader of the base or the leader of the entire IMT. But that's the one person they've come to capture. And I think he's inside that base. And I've basically been blowing up whoever is in the base every single time, causing me to fail the mission. Now, it doesn't tell us that that guy has died. It just gives us the general mission overstatement of that guy having escaped, making me think that there's been a soft timer on this mission. But I suppose that was my policy. My policy was thinking that we had to kill all enemies marked in red. What I've learned from this mission is that some of them sometimes can be your objectives. So you should be a little more careful about who you kill. Now, I know for certain that there are enemies there. What I don't understand is why my bullets are whizzing right past them instead of actually hitting them. Now, this is a very unconventional angle which I've never taken before. For my assaults, I mean. That guy, I did take that guy out recently. No need to fear him. I think the watchtowers are taken care of. I do, however, hear more sniper fire coming my way. I keep getting distracted by the foliage over there. I hope Charlie will be doing fine on their own. But at any rate, I'll go up this hill to investigate. Huh, thought as much. I was expecting some enemies to come over from that side. Oh, that's still just foliage.
Charlie, foliage. We've breached the perimeter.
Enemy? Emily. Good job, Charlie. Please carry on with your mission. Neutralize all hostiles, please. That is, again, just foliage. There are lots of infantry. There's lots of infantry in this base here. And come on, I'm aiming too high these days. No, there are a lot of people shooting at me right now. That much I know for certain. I'm just wondering whether what is Charlie 2 doing? Charlie 2. That guy is illegal. You do not encounter that guy all on your own. Come here now. You cannot take that guy all on your own. Do not attempt to do that. You will soon die if you do try.
Charlie 1 is down!
Told you, Charlie 1. You should have listened. That's your problem, Charlie 1. You don't listen.
Charlie 2 is down!
I think I heard Charlie 2 saying, son of a...
Two at the bunker. Two at the bunker.
Before he died. Like he was about to say the B word. There are more than two at the bunker, actually. There are four inside the bunker, unless you meant two teams. Well, I feel like that is a person, but that probably is not. Now, I need to be careful about how I approach the situation here, because any step could be my last. That being said, that is sort of what makes it exciting. Now, I will not even bother with Charlie. I've been saving them all this time. And, If they can't pick up their own bait around here, then there's really no point to them being Delta Force, is there? There's one person here. Down here. Is there anybody here? Seems to be three people in there. Still alive. Should be another person over there. Yep. The same person who killed Charlie 1 and 2. These people are dead. Now I have to be a little careful, otherwise those guys are gonna get me. As usual, I love the way that the guns dry fire in this game, because that is a little bit, a tiny little attention to detail which a lot of video games miss. Like, most video games don't really incorporate that into their mechanics. Like, they don't really acknowledge the fact that guns can dry fire. Except for Delta Force does that, and I really admire that. Pretty big of Delta Force to do that. Ah yes, there you are. And who else? Is there anybody in there? I suppose not. Should be another person over here. Somewhere over here. I do believe everybody inside of this bunker has been eliminated. That is Alpha 1, Alpha 2. Is that the person? I do not think so. I'm moving towards that person, but I cannot see them yet. Which is sort of distressing. Ah, there he is. I sometimes wonder what these people are shooting at. So, I think the person inside of this hut here, yeah, is the guy that we need to capture. And that I've been accidentally killing him all this time. When I say accidentally, I mean that I do not mean to kill him, but I do anyway. Now, I need to be a little cautious when approaching this guy, because...
Alpha 2 is down! Ah!
Yeah. So, because it's that every single time... Now, how did Alpha 2 die? Nobody was shooting at him. So, this guy here? It's just that every single time I blow up this hut, it hits me with the mission over report. And I sort of realized that after a break, because I sort of took a break. Oh, I should have changed this gun. This guy isn't firing at me though. Yep, that's the guy. That's the guy. You come with us, sir. Whew. So, what I've been doing is I've been shooting this guy from the outside, because it's so risky to open and clear a room in this game. And in doing so, I have been, you know, ending the mission for myself every single time. I sort of got cued enough to break, because I remember that the first time I completed this mission, I thought I had successfully completed it. I had actually killed this guy, and immediately it told me that the mission was over. So yeah, I mean, it's sort of sneaky how they do that. They don't even highlight the objective on the map. But yeah, at least this guy isn't shooting at us, so it sort of serves as sort of a lesson, I guess, in not eliminating, neutralizing, or pacifying or suppressing targets that are not hostile towards you. Even though these are terrorists, so they don't have any legal combatant rights, but still. Congratulations, 41 kills. Congratulations on the job well done, Bravo team. Terrorist leader has been captured and turned over to the government of Indonesia for trial. Prior to handing him over to Indonesian law enforcement officers, Jaden was able to learn the exact location of the base where the stolen CDC bioagents are located. Bravo team is ordered to proceed immediately to the special operations base near the city of Sorong to prepare for the raid on that base. Ground Zero. Now, I'm pretty sure that this is the final, the ultimate mission of the Indonesia campaign. So, retrieve stolen CDC materials from a terrorist base, designated objective zones. So, I will leave today's video right here, and the next time we arrive, we will be addressing Ground Zero. Thank you for tuning in to watch Lockdown. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.